the part of the church cannot happen, the rebound of the church cannot happen unless we have accepted the pain of producing. The pain of producing is not a bad pain. It is a pain that is wiped out by the gift that comes forth. The Bible says, it's like a woman who cries, who feels pain at giving birth, but immediately she sees the child, she forgets the pain. That's a good thing about the pain of fruitfulness. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, what are the signs of our productivity in regard to the Great Commission? Remember, God has recruited you into the kingdom. You are being converted. I want to believe everybody here is born again. You are being converted. Now, God is developing you. The process of discipleship is a process of making you Christ-like. It's a process of turning you to look like Christ. It's a process of making you a better person than you were yesterday. So that you may stand like Paul and say, I was a murderer, but now, by the grace of God, I am what I am. What a glorious position. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, makofi. Before we go further, there is conversion, and then there is your commitment. Your commitment leads to your growth. Am I talking something here?
Yes.
There is the conversion. You are being born again. You were going to hell, now you are going to heaven. You were a sinner, now you are a saint. But there is a demand for your commitment. Your conversion is free. You just need to say yes to Jesus. But your commitment and your growth will cost you everything. Availability, time, commitment. We are studying the book of Acts. Those that are here on Tuesday. And last week we were doing Acts chapter 2, right? And we saw Acts chapter 2 from verse 42. That they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching. Devoted. Not just attended. Devoted. 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 Devotion. Devoted. It is exaggerated. It is a deeper level of commitment. They devoted to the apostolic teaching, breaking of bread, and the Lord added to their number those that were being saved, to prayer, to fellowship. You remember that? Acts chapter 2, 42 to 47. Commitment, and then leading to your growth. And then after your growth, there must be your contribution. So conversion, commitment, contribution. So if you are not contributing in the church, and I'm not talking about contributing money, I'm talking about contributing to the kingdom. Kingdom contribution. What are you doing? Do you have a missionary attitude? And we are going to break those things. Number one, signs that we are fruitful is that there will be new believers in the church. Any church that does not have new believers, people that are getting born again consistently and constantly. Ukienda kanisa upate mtu ambaye ana ushuhuda nyepesi yule aliyeokoka 5 years ago. No matter how big that church is, it is dead. The sign of your fertility is producing. You cannot be fertile and you don't have newness. Ng'ombe ambayo inazaa ndio inatunzwa. I grew up in the village and I know kuku ambaye inataga mayai mingi, you treasure it. Na ikilalia mayai inaangua zote. Kuna kuku zingine inalalia mayai 20 inatoa kifaranga moja na inatoka ikiwa mgonjwa. Hiyo unaua. Bwana asifiwe sana. Ama si ukweli jameni? Sasa inalalia mayai 20 na kuna kuku ambao walikuwa wazuri kwa kuangua mayai. Kwa hivyo watu wanaipatia vifaranga ama rather mayai ya kuku ingine ambayo iko na ujinga. Unaipatia mayai ya hiyo kuku. Na at the end of the day inaagua zake na za hiyo kuku ingine. Lakini kuna zingine very smart, itajua vifaranga zake hata kama iliagua mayai ya wenyewe. Those that have grown in the village, you know those statistics, those, yes. Those tricks.
Yes.
Amen. Charles anaijua nani mkubwa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. Bwana asifiwe sana. Sema amen. There will be new believers. How? Not because the pastor is an evangelist. No, but because every believer is giving back. Every believer is bearing fruits. Let me tell you, revival is not us shouting in church that we are here. Fire! Fire! Shout fire 10 times, fire, 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 fire. Shout electricity 15 times, electricity, electricity, electricity. Shout transformer 7 times, transformer. You can shout transformer without being transformed. I'm telling you the truth. Revival, let me tell you, it can come with calmness. It can come with without a lot of jitters, but as long as there is productivity. New souls, new believers. Mtu anasimama anasema nilikuwa mwenye dhambi, nikakutana na Emaka, akaniombea nikaokoka. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hiyo kama hujaifanya contribution kama hiyo, naomba roho ya utasa ishi. Na kutoka leo uende huo, hata kama ni makanga au kimlipa pesa, unamwambia by the way nimetoka church, hata hii ni change ya sadaka na unaanzia hapo, anzia mahali. Tell them about Jesus. Ambia Mungu lazima mimba yangu, lazima nibebe mimba leo na lazima nizae katika jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Kata utasa. Amen.
Amen.
Kata kuwa tu kwa kanisa ukisema Yesu ni Bwana. Huyo Yesu ni Bwana, wacha aonekane huko nje. Your only contribution in church is not to shout amen. You can contribute more than an amen. I say you can contribute more than an amen. Tunaweza shout hapa tukisema we are taking the city. We will take the city if you can rise up and do your part. Produce. I say produce. Somebody told me a very good thing that shepherds don't give birth to sheep. It is sheep that mate and produce. To increase the herd, the shepherd does not give birth. I remember amezaa kondoo anasema kesho ndazaa nyusi. Unapata ndio hiyo ati yako leba amezaa kondoo anasema niko na kondoo wengi sana. No, it is the sheep that produce. Lift up your hands and receive the grace of productivity.
Amen.
I say may you become fruitful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say my father, anything that has hindered my fruitfulness,
amen,
destroy it in Jesus' name.
Destroy.
Can I hear your loudest amen?
Amen.
So, number two, if there is fruitfulness, we will see discipleship. At a corporate level, at a personal level. What is discipleship? Discipleship is mobilizing and teaching new believers kingdom ways. Mobilizing them for ministry. Mobilizing them for service. And teaching them worldliness can only be achieved by teaching them kingdom ways. The reason why we have half-baked believers is because they came to church and they were never disciples. Watu walikuja kanisani lakini hawakufunzwa neno la Bwana. We have believers in church who don't believe. They are believers but they don't believe. So we will see discipleship at a personal level. Tutaona taifa ako na mtu anaendelea kudisciple. Akikosa kabisa tunasikia taifa amemwendea. Is there somebody that you are discipling? Because that's a sign that you are producing. Kuna mtu unalea. Kuna mtu unamfuza neno. Is there somebody that can say this man has been bothering me, but he has made me to become better than I was? Let me tell you, if you cannot do that at your level, you will never do it as a pastor. If you cannot do it to one person, you will never do it for 1,000 people. Wale ambao mnaomba mkiambia Mungu, give me anointing for 10,000. Begin with one. He will stay with the very little. Shall be entrusted with much. If you cannot disciple one person successfully, wacha kuambia Mungu unataka kuwa kama Bishop Doug Howard. Bishop Doug Howard is into thousands and millions. Trust God that you may become productive. And discipleship is about mobilizing new believers for service. Teaching them kingdom ways. Teach them about faith. Teach them about giving. And how will you teach if you are not learning? That's why you must mature. Don't stay in church for 10 years and you are the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. You are taking the place of God. Not to make up a church. Their own testimony is powerful. I am the same yesterday, today. You look like the rock of ages. Break it. Tell God I must rise above where I am. I must become what I should be. I pray for somebody here, 2019 you shall be different.
Amen.
I don't like your amen. I say 2019 you shall be different.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, mkono juu sema hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout a better hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number two, when we are productive, there will be practice and obedience of God's word.
And I'm saying practice and obedience, not just teaching. Teaching is good, but teaching is basic.
Let me tell you. Wakati unajua ungekaa kwa darasa ukiwa high school, unafanya theory, unasikia unaweza pata kila kitu. Ukienda kwa lab, hata kwenye ulisikia inaitwa venia kalima, auioni. Bwana asifiwe sana. Unajua kuichora, one day I was with a young man, he was in form 1, na nikamuuliza what's a Bunsen burner. Akaniambia hapo hatujafika. And he was drawing it was an assignment. Alikuwa anaendelea kuichora. So hakujua kama nimeiona ndio namwambia fanye nini? I define. Akaniambia hatujafika hapo bado, tuko introduction. Na anaendelea kuichora. Naona anaandika luminous flame na luminous flame. Anaichora. You can be very good in theory. You can teach powerfully about giving, but you are not a giver. You can preach powerfully about holiness and your cohabiting. That's why I'm saying practice and teaching. You can sing powerful songs, but practicing the song is a problem. You can carry a big Bible, but demonstrating a big lifestyle in response to obedience, or rather in regard to obedience of the one written there, is very difficult. You can wear a collar like a reverend, but you can only remain with the collar. You can be powerful in the pulpit, but practicing and obedience. When the Bible says, thou shalt not lie. Are you lying? Yesterday I confronted a brother. Tumesimama na yeye. Na anadanganyana. Tunaenda. Na ananieka. Kasikia ameambia mtu kwa simu, ati tunakuja, tumetoka. Na tumekaa. And I was like, are you serious? Is this real? Can you just lie comfortably? That's why I'm saying practicing the word. It's not easy. You need grace. Hata wengine labda umedanganyana uko nyumbani na uko church. Because unapengine there was something coming up, ukasema niko church. Some of us lie lies and others lie secondary lies. Secondary lies is when you try to speak. That's my word, it's not in the Bible. The secondary lie is when you try to speak and then you want to insinuate something that you don't mean. Unaambia mtu alafu unaacha some gray areas so that in case you are discovered, you can either fix it this way or fix it this way. Unasema hatutaki masai. Ukiulizwa unasema nilisema hatutaki masai. You remember that lie? That's what I'm talking about. You can coin it anyway and get delivered. There's a time the governor of Kiambu, Waititu, incited people against Masai. So when he went to court, he said, akusema Masai, alisema Masai. Akusema Masai watoke, akasema hapana, nilisema Masai watoke. He was misquoted by the media. Oh. Amen. Amen. Wengine ndio wanadanganya Mungu na kupenda ni wewe peke yako. Na unajua tu unadanganya. Mungu na kupenda ni wewe peke yako, hakuna mwingine. Na kumbe ulikuwa unataka rent. Wengine wanadanganya mpaka Mungu. Mmoja Jeremiah aliambia Mungu umenidanganya. Na nikadanganyika. Jeremiah was tough. He told God, you lied to me and I was deceived. Neno lilidanganya, nikadanganyika. You never get there in Jesus' name. Number four. Maturity is demonstrated by how much of the word we practice, not how much of the word we know. It is better to know little and practice it than to know much and practice nothing. Because sometimes we tend to think that the number of scriptures we can memorize is a sign of maturity. No, it is the number, it is the practice of the word, the obedience of the word. How much we practice is more important than how much we know. I think I'm talking to somebody here.
Yes.
How much we practice is more important than how much you know. Listen. You don't look for people and you don't appreciate people that know scriptures. You appreciate people that practice scriptures. Mahatma Gandhi said that I love the Christ of Christians. He read the Bible and he loved Christ. But I don't like the Christians of Christ. Ever known that some of the things that make non-believers not to be born again is how we live our Christianity. I have heard of people, I even heard of somebody saying this, a believer, Pastor Julian, saying that he has a problem with believers. You know, he's a businessman, he has companies. And he was saying that he has a problem hiring believers. Because they will be late for work and they come speaking in tongues. They know scriptures. No weapon formed against me, even the manager and the supervisor. 1,000 shall fall by my side, and you are late for work. 10,000 by my right hand side shall never come near me. I heard of a company that part of their interview is that they ask if you are born again. And once they discover you are born again, they don't recruit you. Because when you are demoted, you threaten them with a curse. I am the seed of Abraham. Whoever shall fight against me shall fight God. And you are being demoted based on your lack of performance, poor performance. We don't practice. We try to misuse the anointing and the power. We think we can mess on life principles and fix them with anointing. No. Brethren, no. You can't fix it with anointing. What you can acquire by discipline, you cannot acquire by prayer. What you can acquire by discipline, I want to beg you and tell you, you cannot acquire by prayer. If you have not pursued a diploma, a certificate, a degree, you cannot get it on the prayer mountain. You have to go to class. Degrees are not printed in heaven. I release a degree. After releasing, go to an institution, apply for that diploma. I release it, and God, I'm so specific, it has to be first class. Thank you, Jesus. Upper division, honors, come on. After that, look for an opportunity. Go sit down in class, even if the lecturer is not born again. Our practice of the word, when you are away from believers, fellow believers, and especially from your fellowship, how do you behave? How do you talk? How do you behave in the public? Somebody has messed around. What do you do? What's your reaction? How quick are you to condemn others? Makanga amechelewa na change yako. How do you behave? Your practice of the word will bring others to the kingdom. And let me tell you the truth. It is clear, and the devil knows, that a practicing believer is stronger than a knowing believer. That's a sign that we are productive and fruitful. And that's a sign of our maturity. Why am I talking about maturity in line to fruitfulness? Because you cannot be fruitful if you are not mature. You know, maturity has to come with fruitfulness. Number one, maturity determines your usability. You are more usable, mature, when you are mature. Only few things are important when they are immature. Kuna mimea ukulwa kabla iive, ama ikomae. Kama kuna moja ikamba inaitwa yongo. It's a type of a pumpkin. Wakati ijakauka unaweza ingiza kidole ndani, hiyo ndio wakati inakula. But I don't know. But mango, unripe mango brings malaria. So you are more usable when you are mature. Sitting down there calling yourself a new believer for 10 years is not adding anything to the kingdom. When will you ever recruit others? When will you be usable? So your maturity level determines your usability. And maturity is when you can be entrusted, when you can be responsible, when people can hold you by your hand and you can take responsibility over issues of life. Issues of life. You can take responsibility over mistakes and correct them. Let me tell you what responsibility is. Responsibility, if you divide it into two, it is response and ability. So responsibility is ability to respond. Responsibility is the ability to respond. Your responsibility level is your response ability.
level.
Maturity comes as a result of commitment, not age. You can be born again for long, but you are shallow. You are immature. God has never told us to be old in salvation. He has told us to grow, to mature. He wants us to grow from babies to maturity. You can grow old without growing up. Self-drive is a sign of maturity. I'm just mentioning a few things about maturity. And then reliability. So that's very important. At a certain age, Jesus departed and he left the disciples. And he told them, go and make disciples. They obeyed and they were reliable. Jesus never came to supervise what they were doing. Am I speaking to somebody here? Have you ever seen Jesus coming to supervise the disciples? They encountered challenges Jesus had never encountered. And at that level, they were able to respond. So, maturity says that you can fix something even in the absence of your leader. Maturity says you can be reliable. And that is to show that you are getting to a place where you can be fruitful. Because if you are mature and you are reliable on your own, others can rely on you. When you are not reliable on your own, nobody can rely on you. Where I'm coming from, I was telling them that. I've never seen any institution that promotes you for doing bad. For example, Naskia Oyo deputy, he has not performed well. Let's see what he can do as a principal. Am Oyo capacitor, not doing well. Let's see what he can do as a pastor. Akapa was asked, what's a capacitor? He said, he's a small pastor. So Oyo capacitor, Afanye Kizuri, let's see what he can do as a pastor. So the other thing that shows our fruitfulness or signs of our fruitfulness, number five, commitment to ministry. God wants every one of us to be committed to ministry, serving Christ. Some of them may be physical things in the church. It is a sign of maturity to see you coming and making sure the curtains are clean. This is good. That's a sign of maturity. Commitment to Christ. Because I've told you there is conversion and there is commitment. One of the commitment levels is commitment to Christ, to serving Christ. Commitment to ministry. Do you have something that you feel like, if I don't do it, I have not served the Lord? You may be a choir member, but are you a committed choir member? The Bible says everything you do it as though you are doing for Christ himself. Now, my question is, if when you are doing it as though you are doing it for Christ, it says do it with that diligence. How much more when you are doing it for Christ? How much more?
Kuna watu wanafanyaga, na ndio maana makanisa imejaa mediocrity. Mediocrity. Unaona kanisa, mlango ya kanisa, na unaona mlango ya bar, unatamani kuingia kwa bar. Hata kama wewe sio mlevi. The standard of excellence is in the world, not in the church. Am I saying the truth? Come on, am I saying the truth?
Yes.
Na nimeanza mahubiri mengine, nataka nisaidie watu. Naambia watu wa Nairobi, mkumbuke mapasta wa ushago. Because some of you, the church that you grew, the church that mentored you, back in the village. Village na car, hata wezi peleka watu. Speakers zote hazina tutor. Akisema the Lord is here, ina interpret, na the Lord is not here. Because the system is, kuna mende kwa waya. I don't know, zanania pastor meharibu doctrine. Kumbe anasema ukweli tu ni tuyo shida mnyo. Bwana siwe sana. Mkikaka mixer inaongea ama microphone, wengine mmewaachia wako na zile wireless za 2000. Kanakuanga na mkia hapa. Acha nikwambie mkia inakuanga radio. Haujaisikia microphone inashika radio? Ama you have ever heard such kind of microphones?
Yes.
Pasa anaendelea kuhubiri unasikia classic 105. Imeshika radio. Mnabaki mnaangalia technician, kumbe ni shida ya microphone. Akienda hii, akikuja hapa, kanakamata frequency ya radio. Mike ina shida radio. Unasikia imeshika ki channel cha kikambo huko.
Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Commitment to ministry. What do you do? And let me tell you, there may be something God has put in your life. Remember, you're not just serving God, you're not just serving man, but you're serving God. I've had people that were abandoned by God just to go to Kenyatta Hospital. Every afternoon or once a week. I know, I was told about a lady that resigned from her place of work to feed patients. We don't have full-time ministry. Yeye hajaitwa afungue church. Ameitwa akuwe anapika chakula anaenda Kenyatta. Kwa wale watu ambao wameachwa na watu wao, hawana watu wa kuwapenda, kazi yake ni kuwapelekea chakula and to give them hope. She resigned from her job to do that. I'm telling you the truth. What do you do in the afternoon? You rest, you swim, you do that. Unaekelea miguu kwa sofa set, unakanyaga TV, unafanya hivi. Where will God reward you for resting? Have you ever seen anywhere that God is saying you rested well? Huh? Will God ever reward you for resting? How do you spend your free time? When you are not in church, let me tell you, ministry is not just in church. Ministry is actually outside church. Amka, go to your neighborhoods. Wapi, I want to tell you about Jesus. That is commitment to ministry. And it demands a high level of discipline. Some of you can even gather village children or children in your estate. Teach them the Bible. Wazazi wao wakikuja wakutusi, hiyo ndio inaitangwa persecution. Waambie walijileta, enda tena wafunze kuhusu Yesu, waambie kuhusu Yesu. Hao wazazi wao waendagi shule wakati wanaingizwa kwa Illuminati. Akifunzwa banki anaendagi complain. Kalisha hao watoto chini. You can play with them football, but you cannot tell them the word of God. Naanza ukimbizana nao mkizunguka bila za plot ama maua for 2 hours and you're unending. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hebu inua mkono sema Mungu nisaidie. The other thing is commitment to missions, sharing Christ. I said the other commitment to ministry, serving Christ. Commitment to missions, sharing Christ. Once a church can never be productive and be God fruitful if it doesn't have a pattern for missions. There must be a pattern for missions. Taiva, lazima tuanze kusikia. Kuna Sunday ujakuja, umeenda mahali fulani for a mission. Missions. Some of you time may not allow you, but God has given you resources. Give money for missions. Unfortunately, pastors are fundraising for missions, but they are doing the most terrible things I've ever seen. And let me tell you, we cannot get to a place of commitment for missions if we have not come to a place of commitment to growth and commitment to ministry. Because you cannot be effective in the mission field if you have not been disciplined in the church. So shida inaingilia hapo. Tuko na watu ambao wamekaa mahali pamoja miaka 10. You are struggling with the same things that you struggled 10 years ago. How can you be doing your nursery school exam when you're in form 4? Atunaambiwa andika boy, unaandikiwa B, Shimo, Y. And you're in form 4. The problem is not the teacher, the problem is you. Missions. When we rise up and step at a place of going out, now we are producing, amen, I mean, we are becoming fruitful big time, in Jesus' name. I pray that God will raise missioners out of here.
Amen.
Oh, I say may God raise missioners out of here.
Amen.
Ukisikia crusade imetajwa, unapatwa na emergency. Hautaki kuenda. Yeah, the Lord is saying, kila mti, kila town, ama kila branch, ambayo haizai matunda itakatwa. Itakatwa. Kama uzao utakatwa. Tawali za. Pachi kwa mimba ya kiroho, uanze kuzaa mapacha, makondroplets, ile roho iko Kakamega. Niliona wanazaa watoto watano. Kizaa mapacha, you are a joker. You know, commit yourself. place that you can come out of your comfort zone and go for that mission. And one thing that God has put in my heart, that I'm teaching and training my sons and daughters. Learn to spend your money. Learn to spend your resources on the mission ground. What has killed the kingdom is that whenever you are called for a mission, you think about an honorarium. It's not your right. I say it's not your right. Ukiambiwa uende mahali kuhubiri, you want to know what they will give you. That's why people are no longer preaching, because you cannot spend anything from your pocket. Actually, you want to know if it is profitable.
Unafanya hesabu, unaona nilispend 3,000. Nikapata 7. Wow, that was a productive mission. It was fruitful. He has called us to bear fruits.
I'm trusting God that God will put money in your hands so that poverty may never take your ministry. I feel like talking to somebody here. Poverty has taken people's ministries. Kwa sababu wakati hauna kitu, you will begin to adjust your gospel. You can either preach budget. You can preach your budget. Mwambie watu Bwana asifiwe. Niko hapa na sijui nitalipa rent aje, lakini najua Bwana anaweza kuza watu hapa. Hata stima nimekatiwa, hili injili isonge mbele. Pendo hata maji sijui. Mpaka unapata watu wako hivi kwa kanisa wanauliza na gai papa. Huh? Why did God punish him with a call? What did his parents do? Bwana asifiwe sana. I paralyze poverty in your life. May you have money for missions. I say may you have money for missions. May you have money for missions. Tukisema tunaenda Kitui, tunaenda Kitui. Hallelujah. Tukisema tunaenda Makueni, tunaenda Makueni. Unaenda gari yako mafuta, unaweka wifi na tunaenda Kitui. Au tubebe hapo tukiboeka. Sema amen. Pigia Yesu makofi mazuri katika jina la Yesu. Na sio gari yenye unapiga kama umechoka. Haujui ikienda rivers na mbele. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hata mtu hawezi lala, akilala anashikwa na nightmare. Bwana asifiwe sana. Anaanza kuona ma vampires, ma dream what. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nasema Bwana asifiwe sana. Kwa unajua kuna gari unakaliaga tu unalala. Hata huwezi jua bumps ziko wapi. Lakini kuna gari zingine ambapo unajua barabara Kangundo road yote unaijua. Unajua bumps mali iko hata ukidrive usiku kama gari haina taa, you know where to slow. The thing has taught you. May the Lord give you resources. As he remembers me also. May the Lord give you resources in Jesus' name. Shout a big amen. Shout a big amen. Commitment to mission. Say God, I will go in Jesus' name. I pray that we get to a place where we can rise up from here to say that we are going to India. The mission fee is 200,000 and you can pay that money. You can pay that money. What do I want to